Good morning. I'm live from Yashoda Hospital at Somajiguda in Hyderabad, where Madhavi was admitted last night after she and her husband were brutally attacked in the Eragada area of Hyderabad. From what we are understanding, she was brought here in a very critical condition. She had severe blood loss after she was attacked by her father yesterday in the afternoon. So what we are understanding is that the surgery has been completed. It was done by nearly 10 doctors, and her bleeding was brought under control and her vitals were stabilized. The doctors say that it will take another 48 to 72 hours to assert if she will live, but her vitals have been brought to normal. Now it depends on her recovery, but the doctors say that they are confident that she will recover given her young age and the strength that her body would have. Now her hand, which was hurt badly yesterday, which was said to be hanging by skin, the doctor said that they managed to stabilize it, but it will take a few days to know whether the hand can be brought back to normal or will it require to be amputated. And as per her injuries, her jaw, her neck and her ear have been severely hurt in the attack yesterday. To give you an idea, Manohar Achari, her father, attacked Madhavi and Sandeep yesterday in the evening. After a week after they ran away and got married, he has been arrested by the police, and according to the press briefing by the police last night, he has been arrested. He said that the police alleged it was not a caste problem, but that he was extremely anguished and hurt by the fact that she went against his wishes and was not receptive even to coming back after the marriage. He called her to come to Gokul Theatre near Eragada in Hyderabad yesterday on the pretext of arranging a reception. He was heavily inebriated. He had been consuming alcohol for the past 5 days, is what the police say. His blood alcohol level was nearly around 357. And in fact, he wanted to kill the daughter and not the son-in-law. And he brutally attacked Madhavi, after which she has been battling for her life since yesterday. The doctors, a team of four doctors, will shortly brief the media on her exact condition, what went through in the surgery at around 10:30, and we will keep you updated about that. As for the father, he was produced in front of the judiciary last night, and more details from that are awaited. As for the husband, his jaw was hurt, however he is not critical. He has been discharged from Neelima Hospital in Eragada, which is where he was taken to right after the attack yesterday in the evening. He is fine. He is out of danger. He is currently at his residence. Just repeating what her condition is. She is currently, the surgery has been completed. Her vitals are stable. The bleeding has been brought under control, but it is going to take another 48 to 72 hours to ascertain whether she will really live. Her arm, which was brutally hurt yesterday and was hanging by the skin, the doctors say that they have stabilized it, but they really can't tell until the next few days whether the arm will need to be amputated or can it recover. They say the focus right now is on keeping her alive, since her neck, her jaw and her ear, this part of her head has been severely hurt. The team of doctors is going to brief the media shortly about her exact condition and what the course forward will be, and we will keep you updated on that. Thank you for watching.